Hello, Church. I wanted to take just a few moments today and talk to you about some of the things that have been going on that you haven't been privy to, and some plans and preparations that are in the works. Let me first of all say that, you know, we as a leadership team have never led a church through a pandemic before. We don't have a playbook for this. We can't go back and say, oh, how do we typically work through this kind of a situation? Because we've never lived through this kind of a situation. And so we're very much building the bridge as we're walking across it. And because this is an unprecedented time, we know that having the right choices and the right plans in place are greater decisions than we have the capacity to make on our own. So first and foremost, your leadership team has been taking this fervently to God and asking God to give us the wisdom and the guidance to know the right things to do so that we can best bless and protect our church family. And so we want you to know that that's been in the works. First and foremost, prayer, time with God. But we've also been looking out to resources. We've been gathering all the best information we can from the governmental agencies and from the experts in the field, the CDC and the WHO and Ohio State, and even more local levels with health departments to ask questions like, how do we get back to in-person meetings? What does that look like? What kind of safety precautions do we need to take? What are the steps that we need to go through? And so we've been reaching out to experts in the field. And the third thing we've been doing is we've been looking out to other churches, other church leaders, and saying, what are you doing? What are the ideas that you're putting into practice? What are you gathering and what are your plans looking like? And to all that end, what we've done is we've created a team of people that are inside the church and outside the church that are going to help us walk step by step through what it means for us to get back to those in-person meetings that we all so very much want to get back to. I'm anxious to get back to them. I know you're anxious to get back to them. I can't wait till we can all be back in that building again and the big warm hugs and the handshakes and the high fives and everything that we miss so much right now. And we're anxious to get back, but we want to do it right. And we want to do it safely because we're so very important. It's so very important to us that our members are kept healthy and that no one is endangered by the choices that we make. So we have these plans in place that we're starting to create. We have a team that's working with us. First and foremost, we're taking everything to God and very humbly asking for His direction and guidance. And so I can't tell you right now what that plan is ultimately going to be. I can tell you there's a lot already that started. But one thing that I can tell you definitively today, and this is the reason for this announcement, is that we're announcing today that we are not going to be having any in-person meetings until at least June. The plans that we have in place are for a very gradual and slow return to normal, where incrementally parts of our in-person services are brought back together over time. And we do this so that we can maintain the safety and health of all of our members and visitors and the people in our community. But we believe that the very best way to do that is to make sure that we have a very solid plan and a start date that looks to be in keeping with what the experts are telling us is the safest time. The plan will be coming out soon. We'll have more details to come, but we want you to know that the plans are being worked on, that your leaders are doing everything we can to make sure that we provide a safe restart. But we know that won't be until at least June. And between now and then, the team's going to be meeting regularly. And if you have ideas, insights, thoughts, do not hesitate to share those with us because your input is very valuable to us. We are so much wanting to be together, but to do so safely means that we have to be diligent and careful, and through every decision of life, the small ones and the very large ones like this, we're a people who recognize that prayer is the means by which good things happen and guidance from God is received. We appreciate your feedback. We appreciate your patience and continue to pray for our church family as we navigate these very uncharted waters to this point. God bless y'all.